We're on the Feather River with guide Rafe Herford, along with Francis Hopping and Jody Way. We're hooking up with some of the Feather Steelhead, which may seem surprisingly small. We have more fishing to do on the Feather, but first, here's Robert Weiss of the NorCal Guides and Sportsmen's Association, who is running us up to Sacramento to the famous barge hole to explain why the steelhead are so small. It all begins with the salmon runs.
Normally here in barge hole, this time of the year, we'd be fishing for fall run king salmon. It'd be 50 to 100 boats here, all of everybody catching fish and having a good time. Here we are in 2023. Two boats I see, no fish jumping. I want to talk a little bit about the four distinct runs of salmon in the Sacramento Valley. That would be the main rivers and tributaries. Historically had four runs of king salmon. They had a fall run, they had a spring run, they had a late fall run, and they had a winter run. And basically over the last 50 years, those runs have basically depleted themselves to the point where one distinct run goes, then the next one goes, because all the salmon depend on each other having four distinct runs. So that's why we're having problems on the rivers and the tributaries, is that we lost one run of fish, and when you lose that, it's just a cycle of losing all the runs. It's like riding your bicycle and you take a spoke out of the wheel, it doesn't run very good, and then all of a sudden another one falls off. Pretty soon your wheels fall off. That's where we are on the Sacramento River now. Steelhead are basically a derived fish from salmon historically. They're related, trout and steelhead. And a question is always asked a lot is, why are the steelhead smaller on the Sacramento and Feather River? And the reason being is that our salmon fishery and natural spawning salmon in these rivers they're basically non-existent anymore. So that's a big food source for the steelhead. And that's why they're so small. They just don't have enough food in the river to survive at the older ages where you would see the steelhead getting bigger. If you want to improve the steelhead fishing and the size of the fish, we have to start out with the salmon. We have to bring the salmon back. And when we get the salmon coming back and spawning naturally, you'll have the derived nutrients in the water. And you'll see larger sizes and better populations, because there'll be more food in the river, which typically when you have good steelhead runs, you'll have good salmon runs. They go together. And you need years of good runs of salmon to really bring the steelhead back. Steelhead, generally, when they get to the larger sizes, they're generally just like a salmon, 3 to 5 year old fish. And that's what we need coming back. Currently, we're having generally about 1 to 2 year old fish coming back, and then very few of the larger size on all of the rivers. So we need to improve the salmon, and the steelhead will come back. I would like to see, once we start getting some salmon coming back, that we do improve the hatchery production for steelhead, which would be a very good thing for us. We've got some great programs started that hopefully we can bring the river back and bring the fish back. We got one program currently where we take the carcasses from Battle Creek. That's the salmon carcasses. They spawn those out, and we take them and distribute them along the river through here, through a section of river where we typically would have natural spawning. We're trying to build up the derived nutrients for the juvenile fish and the inward migrating steelhead, because the environment needs salmon. Salmon are the foundation of the food chain on our river systems and tributaries. And when we lose the salmon, we lose all the other organisms and fish and wildlife that depend on the salmon, because they are the foundation of the food chain on this Sacramento River system. Sacramento River rainbow trout, if you were to tell if it was a steelhead, it would be longer than 18 inches. And he would have his adipose fin removed. That's how we track our fish. So this is a native rainbow trout. So this is one of our salmon carcasses that we put back in the river about 2 weeks ago. And this is one of our location points that we like to put the fish in. A lot of juvenile salmon and steelhead like to live along the river here until they migrate out to sea. And we can see this one has been, it's getting ate on by some sort of creature in the river. These salmon are crucial to have in the river, derived salmon nutrients, as they call it. Everything in the river that lives here needs salmon. So hopefully one day we can bring back a healthy population of natural spawning salmon and steelhead into this river. But since we started this program, we see that it's very beneficial to the river itself. We developed a technique of fish chucking, which is pretty productive. You grab them by the tail, and you chuck them. There you go.